Hola, mi gente.
Hola.
We're now in Dallas. We've been here for a few days, but we've just been spending family time, relaxing. That's why we haven't really been bringing you guys along. But just now, we are right in front of future Dallas Junbi location.
Junbi.
Casey's family, the Chan clan, they are franchisees. They will be opening their own store here in, what is this, Plano?
Richardson.
Yeah, Richardson. They haven't started any construction yet. I believe they are just finished signing the leasing papers and all that stuff.
First quarter next year. Or, I mean, if this law comes out by next year, then 2021.
So this place, it used to be like a smoothie place or something?
Yeah, pops, puree bowls, coffee. And more pops, puree bowls, and coffee.
But anyway, we're really excited about this location because it's nestled in a perfectly walkable space. And for Texas standards, there's not a lot of walkable spaces. So we're actually really excited about this location. And just to bring Junbi to Texas, because I know a lot of you guys have been super excited, wanting to try Junbi for yourselves. And now you can come to Richardson, a suburb in the Dallas area, to try Junbi for yourself.
My family's opening up 3 Dallas locations, so this is just the first one. We haven't figured out the other 2 locations, but that will be to be a announced.
TBA.
Yeah, TBA, but what does it stand for? To be
announced.
Announced. Yeah, all right. Wanna do this
though
real quick?
Oh yeah, you wanna peel it? So I already peeled this side.
We are vandalizing.
Ta-da!
Now we have a blank canvas to work with.
Yay! Let's check out the inside. Ah, look what we have here. There's Mama and Baba way over there. But yeah, this location actually looks pretty similar to the one that we have in Roland Heights, I would say. And actually Westwood a little bit too.
Yeah, it's like if you've been to the LA location, this layout is literally the same exact thing, except it's just stretched out long ways.
Mm-hmm.
Like bigger long ways. Yeah, it's pretty simple. We're gonna have some basic seating areas here. And then originally, but my parents were trying to find a bigger space. And then with like the pandemic and stuff for the first location, for now, I think it's just kind of made more sense to get a smaller place.
A little more compact.
We can't fit too many. You're not supposed to fit too many people in stores and you know, just business-wise. It's a little slower in terms of indoor seating. A lot of people are buying and taking it home and whatnot. Mm-hmm. There's a lot more to-go stuff. Anyways, a lot of seating here. And then the foot traffic's gonna go this way. We're gonna have like our Junbi artwork.
Yeah, the arches.
On this wall. This is the previous spot, very naked. Kind of cashy, I like it, very naked. Kiosks will be here, so you can order on a kiosk or you can order.
Yeah, contactless ordering.
Contactless, but either way, this is the ordering station. Drinks will be made back here, and it'll be delivered on this side, just like our Roland Heights location.
And then right back there is a bathroom.
Bathroom.
And then right over here we have Baba.
Yay.
Are you excited?
Yes, I am.
You sound so excited. Just kidding. But yeah, when do you guys project to open?
I hope it's end of January.
End of January.
End of January.
First week of February.
That's really? That's so fast.
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh my gosh, because we're.
It's already done.
Yeah, this place is pretty much ready to go.
That's true, just the aesthetics.
Aesthetics, yeah. The facade needs to change.
The infrastructure, the sewer, the water, and the light is all pretty much done.
True. Yeah, because right now we're in the end of December, so that's really, really, really soon. Hi, Mama.
Hi.
Hi. You excited to be a Junbi franchisee?
Yes, can't wait until it opens.
You're preparing daringly?
Daringly preparing.
But yeah, and then right back over here, we just have a lot of storage space. There's gonna be the refrigerators and I don't know what else because I'm not really involved with these plans, but yeah, it's the location. It's super exciting. I can't wait. I think the next time that we come, it's probably gonna be for the grand opening.
I think so.
Yeah,
and then
they're gonna be coming over LA to train. So maybe like in January, they're gonna come over. They're gonna be training and we get to spend some more family time together. And then they get to see our house because now it's like fully.
Oh yeah, the last time they came, we had just moved in.
It was literally the beginning of lockdown. Early March. And we had just moved in, like 2 weeks.
It feels like, honestly, it does not feel like it was that long ago. It's so crazy that it's almost been a year now.
Almost a whole year. These past few days, like I said, we've just been hanging out. We got to check out Carrie's house. So Casey's brother's home? Because yeah, the last time we saw his home was, they had just moved in too.
Well, yeah, so they did a lot of work.
Yeah, they did a lot of stuff, so it's been pretty cool. Very relaxing. We miss Isaac terribly, but we've been talking to him on Discord and stuff. He has like his own Discord account, so we've been chatting.
It's cute because he's like really new to chatting and stuff. Like he'll say like really simple things, and I'm like, so what are you doing? He's like, watching YouTube.
Yeah.
Like, cool. But like in person, it's not the case though. In person, it's like he talks. Like he likes to express himself a lot. So it's interesting to see his online personality starting to take shape.
All right, now we are at my brother's house.
And actually, we were already home. I just wanted to walk in.
Hi, Carrie.
Hey.
My brother.
I was gonna change, but I realized you guys were doing this already.
We gotta keep the show moving. All right. So
hi, Mama.
Hi.
Kitchen. we haven't vlogged my family in a long time. Like so, like my family, we usually meet up like in LA or in Dallas or somewhere around the world. I want to say like every 3 months or so. And like because of the pandemic though, we haven't actually met up in so long. So. Like in like over like nine months, something like that, right?
Hey!
You look nice and comfy.
Yeah, my haircut.
Yeah, it looks good. Brand new haircut. Let me get a close up of this haircut. There we go.
Yeah.
Hi, Diana.
I was trying to be like so quiet because I have all these bowls rattling and I'm like,
oh, no worries.
No, you're good.
Oh, make a mess. Let's do it. So, what are we doing today, Diana?
We are making suadero tacos.
Ooh.
I think Carrie already started doing the marinade. And I'm about to start making like the salsas, the guac, some Jamaica water. Ooh. Or really, I'm just gonna make like
nice.
A few little different things so we can have something that's not
on. Yummy.
Sweet. Did you guys bring the oysters?
Yep, there's oysters in this bag.
Yes. These are the tacos I'm marinating. We're doing suadero, which is basically this part of the cow.
Oh, really?
between the belly and like their leg, which and with the American cuts, it doesn't exist.
Mm.
Yeah, so it's like strictly like a Mexican beef.
Ooh, interesting.
Just for
I didn't know that.
Yeah,
we went teaching to a, me about we my went, own culture.
We went to a butcher shop and we were trying to ask for this suadero piece.
Yeah.
And they basically took us to like the back office where they had like this diagram of a cow.
Uh-huh.
Said, are you sure you want this piece?
Yeah.
It's like a sexy time piece right here.
So basically that piece doesn't exist for them. Like it's part of a, it's like that, this part is like part of different cuts.
How come you wanted that cut specifically?
That's what suadero is.
Or like why suadero? Suadero.
Because I really like tacos. I really like the weird meats that people aren't used to that are in Spanish words.
Mm-hmm.
That's true.
And every time I go to a taqueria, I always go for those kind of meats. And I don't know, I just like suadero.
Yeah, I like buche, lengua.
Cabeza.
I don't think I've tried cabeza.
Cabeza is a little much for me. Like when I eat cabeza, like if it's not marinated right or whatever, or cooked, or it's not chopped too finely, you're chewing into it and you're like, oh yeah, I'm chasing some brain matter here.
Really? Gross.
Well, I think there's different parts of cabeza because I think you told me it's either head or neck. Mm-hmm. So I think it could be either. It could be the head, or it could be the neck.
Like cheek meat or something.
Yeah. So yeah, it could be different. And the only meat that I've never enjoyed. It could just be this one time. Is I think goat.
Chiva.
Yeah. I don't know.
I like it in birria.
I think it was the way it was marinated or something. Like I don't think it's the actual meat itself. It was just the taste of everything else they did to it. Mm-hmm. I didn't like.
Dude, next time you guys come out to San, it's like to West Coast. We've got to make a trip to San Diego because there's this restaurant in San Diego that serves only. Ojos? Oyos?
What?
Ojos? Eyes.
Yeah, they only serve eyes.
I'm weird.
Like, I want to eat that.
I remember you saying something about like it was cabeza only or something.
Maybe it was cabeza.
Yeah, I don't think it was ojos. I really
eyes
doubt it was.
Kind of weird to only serve eyes.
Yeah, I don't think it was eyes.
But it was intense. It was something super intense, and you're like, this is not attracting a mainstream audience. This is like a
those
very
are the
niche.
Kind of tacos I like.
Yeah.
So you, we gotta go there. For
okay.
You,
I'm down.
Weird stuff.
I'm down.
But anyway, we were doing a tour of your house. Hope you don't mind.
Okay. So the only thing is I haven't cleaned my room.
Yeah, we're not gonna go there. So don't worry.
Yeah, cause we got back from Denver, so and also before packing for Denver, we just kind of rushed everything,
yeah.
Just to try to get everything ready and the holiday.
I mean, we're just gonna show the main area. So like right here. So for example, we have the kitchen.
It looks a lot more furnished than the last time we vlogged.
Oh yeah. Let me get my other cat out. Let me get Tootie.
Oh yeah, Tootie.
Baby hid, but let me.
Yeah, Tootie's new. She's a new girl.
This right here is Tootie.
Hi, Tootie.
We got her March of 2019. She was about 6 months old. She was a little stray cat. Somebody had found her and they
her story.
This is like that Sarah McLachlan. Yeah.
In the eyes. Yeah,
yeah,
she's
we got
so
her
fluffy.
From the shelter. She was like $12.
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
If you adopt the animal, they're like really cheap.
Oh,
what?
Yeah, cool.
She's so cute and so fluffy.
Hi, $12.
She's really friendly.
Tootie booty. She's super cute. Yeah, she's super friendly too. Like Vivi, so they have another cat named Vivi and she's also super fluffy, but she's very antisocial. So Tootie's the opposite.
Vivi used to get bullied by my mom's cat, Moo Moo.
Oh, Moo Moo.
So
yeah.
She has like,
she learned.
She has like this.
She's traumatized.
Traumatized.
Yeah,
PTSD. Oh, but not Tootie.
Nope, Tootie never learned to be scared of humans.
Nice.
Anybody can walk up to her and she won't run away.
Aww. Cutie.
She could easily be kidnapped, so that's also really scary.
Oh no.
That is scary.
Yeah.
I just walked close to her and she said, shh, shh. I said, okay,
wow.
Alright, okay, calm down.
Tootie was there too, right?
Yeah, Tootie's. Let me pet her.
Yeah.
Aw, you good girl. She wants to go outside.
Yeah, she does.
She's like, let me out. Do you want to continue the talk?
Let's do it. So yeah, we got the kitchen, the dining room over there. Everything in my brother's house is super mid-century
modern.
We have the notes already. Living room, very mid-century modern. I am jealous of the size of the layout.
Yeah.
So
like
size-wise, it's relatively the same in terms of the size of the actual house, but the layout, the way it's done, this is a living room.
I wish I kind of like tidied up a little.
Workout thing, you know, doesn't look very good.
Oh yeah, I used that and that tore me up.
We're getting that.
I ordered a different one.
That you were talking about.
Yeah, I did. I ordered that one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah. If you guys don't know what this is
okay, oh yeah, demonstrate.
So you put your phone here, right?
It's not sponsored.
Yeah, not sponsored. So you put your phone down there and
you play a little game.
Little game pops up on through the app. You know how I said when you told me about it, you're like,
oh,
last like
God.
A minute. And I'm like, what, really? You can't last like 10 minutes or something? And you're like, no, 10 minutes is impossible. And I got on and I did a minute too, and I was like, yeah, 10 minutes is impossible.
I did a minute, I think I lasted, so I did it twice, and each time I think it was like 35 seconds.
All right, and then now you go into a plank. So you see, I'm in a plank. Holy crap, okay, we're driving. I already died.
And it totally like it activates your inner core to the max to the point where I was dying for the next 2 days. It was crazy.
All right, so now we're driving in a motorcycle, but you have to activate. Oh my God. And every time you crash, you got her swivel.
You're using a whole bunch of muscles you never used before.
I know exactly. Oh my God. All right. I think I'm good. I lasted 39 seconds.
Oh dang.
So yeah, we're good. So I had a good workout.
I know, you're gonna get that six pack now?
That's a keg. Always a keg. So the factory had the most changes since the last time we were really good.
Yeah.
Look how cool this deck is.
I know, and then they added this roof thing with like a daylight.
So a little preface, we had a really bad contractor do this, so that's why this thing is falling out.
Oh, I didn't even notice that.
And when it rains a lot, it actually, you can kind of see the marks, but it'll start dripping here.
Oh no.
I mean, it's leaking. Yeah, it's not, I mean, it's
too deep.
Terrible.
She's like, yes, I'm outside.
But yeah. Advice for everyone out there, make sure you really vet out your contractor. So it turns out he did ghost out a lot of my, or people who live around here.
Yeah.
I think we got the best deal. He at least finished our job with other people. He basically just would do half the job, take the money, and then just never show
up. That's horrible. Yeah.
Aesthetically, it looks really cool.
Yeah, it looks really good.
Well, if you look at it like that, it's kind of like, down here, it's like sloping back down.
Oh, I can see that. True.
I mean, if you do construction, you can tell this is not a great job.
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah.
Oh my gosh, why are you scaring her?
No, she's having fun.
But yeah, you're learning about construction though because you started a flipping home business.
Trying to get into house flipping. still working on a first house. We're stuck on getting permits.
Because of COVID?
Yeah, that's their excuse that they like laid off half of their staff.
Oh, dang.
So that's why everything's moving so slowly. Still trying to learn, but...
Yeah.
You gotta show us your house.
Yeah.
The house you guys flipped.
We will, yeah.
Yeah, I wanna see it.
Yeah, we want to try to vlog our flips, but
we're not vloggers.
So it's tough to like keep up with
We gotta start somewhere.
But yeah.
Yeah.
Just start vlogging.
Well, we did, but then there'd be days like we forget the camera.
And then
it just, you know, it's like it's gonna be all like disconnected.
That's
but
true.
I don't know, whatever.
Maybe yeah.
Still a workaround to everything.
Or even like you could take photos every day and get a time lapse of progress. And then talk over it.
Yeah, a little too late for that also.
Not really.
That's still like 90% of the work's already done.
No, the inside is completely gutted.
Yeah, the inside, yeah. I mean, hopefully you guys get to go see it.
But yeah, I love your backyard and how gigantic it is. I'm so jealous.
Yeah, in Texas standards, this is like a...
small yard.
Yeah, small, medium yard, you know.
Really?
There's all types of sizes, but there's definitely some that are just... huge.
We hung up some lights up here, and then Mama planted all these beautiful flowers. It's a really nice house, but we're gonna be shucking oysters.
You're ready to shuck some oysters? I hear they're an aphrodisiac.
Oh, what does that mean?
Just kidding. Oh, okay. I was like, well, if you want me to explain.
Oh, one time Tootie actually climbed all the way up this tree.
Oh, crazy.
It was pretty scary. It was when she was way younger, so she was lighter. She's scared.
Oh, jeez.
Coming down.
What are you doing? Oh, I thought you were gonna throw her up there.
That was like, wait, wait.
Yeah. Oh, dang.
That's really high.
Up there, and she came down, and because I don't have any branches, like on this lower half,
yeah,
she did not know how to get down.
Oh, no. Did you call the fire department?
I really didn't want to, but yeah. I was trying to get this tall ladder from my dad's house. During that time, she eventually kind of like jumped down.
Oh, true.
Yeah. She like kind of shimmy fell down.
Just playing around. Tootie, you're so cute. You make me miss my Maya and my Zoe.
All right, we are now beginning the oyster shucking. We got some oysters laid out right here on some ice. Harry's got one.
Yep.
Bam, easy.
Good?
Really
good. Show him how the lady showed us.
What you wanna do is you wanna make a little bed, literally with a blanket. And then when you grab your oyster, the soft part, you want it to be up. Yeah, that's good. And then from here, you're gonna be using the towel to basically act as a pillow. And in here, you basically just have to find this tiny, tiny little opening. So what you wanna aim for is gonna be right here, but you wanna angle it inwards instead of outwards.
Like oh, this. Really?
Yeah.
Interesting, okay.
So if you bring
like basically straight down?
More down than horizontal. You're just gonna lightly wiggle it left and right, or side to side, I guess, like this, up and down, until you feel like you're in the inside. There you go.
You got it?
That's so easy.
Yep, and then you're just gonna bring it all the way around.
Yeah, you know, cut the top and the bottom.
Okay, let me protect myself. Get out of here, mofo. Look at that. Cheers, y'all.
That's good. So I have cooked the suadero for about like 1 hour 30. I don't know. I watched this recipe online, and I think they tell you to do it for 2 hours. I don't know. It was all in Spanish, and poured it like on a potato. So I had to have Diana translate it for me the first time, and kind of just try to remember everything.
So this is authentic.
Yes. So I have green onions in here, a lot of lard.
I like how you cooked it the original way too. Like you just had it sticking out the side of the pot.
Yeah, I'm literally just trying to emulate the street version.
Ooh, that looks tender.
Yeah, so this is about two pounds and 3 ounces. I weighed it out and I had stored it for a while. I have one more in here. I don't know where it is. Ah, here it is. Lard, green onions, and I think just a couple pieces of garlic.
Mmm.
Yep. It
smells good. Wow, look at the spread.
So I did my little tortillas.
Nice. Little flight there.
Yeah, that way it's a lot easier to just kind of add everything in there.
Mm.
I don't put a lot of meat just because I like to have all my onions, cilantro, salsas, kind of.
You gotta give room for to load it up.
I personally like to put a lot of cilantro and make a little salad out of it. A little bit of onions. If I had cooked onions, I would have done that.
Oh, grilled on caramelized onions.
Oh, so good, but this will do. Look at this rough chop. It's not even good.
I was eating a Whataburger hamburger the other day, and I realized they don't really chop their onions very well. And I was biting into whole chunks of onions. I was like,
That's an oniony bite. Bam! Just like the streets of Mexico.
Yep.
Taqueria.
Hola mi gente, good morning. We are still in Dallas and today we're actually checking out Carrie, Casey's brother, and Diana's flip home project. So right now we're in the backyard and they got this house, I don't remember when, I gotta ask, but they've been working on this house for some time now. And man, they showed us pictures of what this place looked like before and
it was a dump. Woo,
it was crazy. They actually had squatters here and a lot of like meth head people, I guess. I don't know, just not very good people to take care of this house. And so they were able to purchase it. They've been working on this home for some time now. So we decided to come check it out, show you guys their project. Cause Carrie, how long have you been working on this house?
Like August, September. This is our first flip house, so didn't go very smoothly.
A lot of lessons.
Yeah, we learned a lot of lessons. We're still waiting for the city to give us the permits to finish the rest of the house. So we're kind of like in a purgatory state right now with this project.
What made you start flipping homes? Because first of all, I think just to give a little like insight into what you live through your day-to-day, you run the restaurant here, you're about to start the Joombie, you're about to open the Joombie. You used to run the Code Ninjas, which by the way, we haven't updated you guys, but they actually got rid of the Code Ninjas, they sold it. So they're no longer dealing with the Code Ninjas, and out of nowhere, you just decided to start flipping homes. So what was the inspiration for that?
Well, I guess being a homeowner, you just start paying attention to some more things about houses, so and then true. During the whole entire quarantine, when the restaurant wasn't able to open, we were just kind of sitting at home, just watching a bunch of HGTV flip shows, and just kind of started building an interest in real estate. I'm actually taking the course to get my real estate license.
Oh,
I don't
cool.
know if I'll use it, but
I
want to learn more about it and, you know, hopefully get into the field. I find it very rewarding to, you know, kind of reconfigure a layout of a house and try to basically use what you have and try to make it better.
He's dressing a lot like a real estate agent these days too. It's like, I've always known him to be more of like a sneakerhead kind of person, but like this trip back, like he's like dressed like actually nice.
actually nice.
All right, you ready to walk us through this?
Yeah. Where we're standing right here is what will be the kitchen.
Small kitchen.
Over here, yeah, there's some stuff in the way, but the water connection for the sink over here. And then right behind over here would be like the dining area, and there'd be like a peninsula island that would come out to this post.
Carrie, you were telling me that this whole part of this house was added?
Sort of. So this right here where we're standing used to be a carport.
Before y'all did anything, this is outside right now.
And you can kind of see with the lines of all the concrete. So this whole portion right here was the carport. And then this little awkward space in between was like a closet space. Mm-hmm. And then this square cut out here actually used to be part of the outside. So this part is our really small addition. I'd say maybe 60 square feet or so.
I would still count the carport, because then that was outside, right?
Yeah, it was. So it is added square footage, yes, you're correct.
Yeah.
This front door actually used to be over here. This is a nice color.
I like that wood too.
Nice contrast.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so as you can tell with the driveway, it used to be the carport, so you would just drive straight
all the way in.
And which a lot of the houses in the neighborhood kind of converted the carports over to like a living space.
Yeah.
Just because these houses are so small. I think it was like 800 square feet originally.
Wow,
so
that's
everything
tiny.
That we converted, it's I think around 11 or 1200 now.
Oh, that's cool.
It was a 3-bedroom, 1-bathroom house, and then we're converting it to still a 3-bedroom, but we're adding a master bathroom, like a little master suite.
The reason why now this home is kind of like stuck where it's at, because they can't even finish a lot of the inside yet, right?
And a lot of it's due to COVID, as the city likes to blame it on, which is probably true.
It's ironic, because you started doing the flip houses because of COVID, and you're like, all right, what's something we can do during COVID times with restaurants closed, and now you're actually closed down for the flip home process now too,
yeah,
because of COVID.
Pretty much, yeah. Watch your step, most important thing. And this right here is a laundry room.
Oh.
That's kind of nice, because I don't even have a laundry room. So this is the existing bathroom right here. So that was already there before.
Did you buy that, or was that here?
Yes, so we did buy that.
It's nice.
You know, pre-made already. That's probably the cheapest option, is a pre-made vanity sink thing. Bedroom 2.
You know what sucks that I'm realizing right now? that we probably will never get to see this home once it's completed, because then you're gonna sell it once you're done with
true.
It. So this is actually just only a vlog of seeing bones.
Hello, and goodbye.
Well, we have a potential friend of Diana's that is interested, you know, so if it does work out.
Oh, really? Your friend's gonna buy this?
My friend really wants to buy this house because she lives in this neighborhood, loves the area, but right now she's been renting with her family an apartment. She texted me again and she said, hey, like, you know, how's the house going? We're still really interested.
So oh, cool.
I have a feeling that she, like, if everything works out and if they like it, they really will be buying it. So
cool.
She's a really, really close friend of mine. I'm pretty sure that she'll be more than okay.
Like, yay, then we'll get to see a final view of this place.
This right here is the master bedroom.
That's a tiny room.
It is a tiny master bedroom.
And that's the bathroom? It's a
yes,
pretty big bathroom.
Over there's the bathroom.
That's huge.
That's the bathroom's bigger than the bedroom.
No, it's not.
I mean, it looks
it's
bigger.
Pretty big though.
Yeah. Shower would be right here. And then the vanity, two sink vanity.
Oh, nice.
Will be right along here for his and hers. Or his and his, or hers and hers, whatever.
Back here is gonna be the walk-in closet.
His and hers.
Yep. One side for whoever, and the other side
yeah.
for whoever.
So this is the best we could do. We would love to make everything bigger, but given the space that we do have, this is probably the best layout we can possibly do with the least amount of work. So that's the biggest thing about flipping a house and reconfiguring the layout is you might have a lot of ideas about doing this or that, but then you have to take in consideration of what's actually feasible.
Right.
You know, based on, you know,
like cost and the spacing. Exactly. What'd you say?
I said reality sucks.
Yeah. No, this is really cool. I mean, it's also really fun to think that you guys get to just take something existing and then edit it and see like how creative you could get. Cause just when you were telling me about moving the front door and then adding the carport part to be part of the living room, I'm like, that's so creative. Like I would have never thought of that.
It was my idea.
Yeah, girl.
I think it was all of our ideas.
Oh my God, no.
Let her have it.
Well, anyways, if you guys want to stay updated, you can follow us on Instagram at Chan Homes.
So we wanted to show you guys this project. And if you guys are interested in flipping homes, check out their page. You guys can see, and maybe in the future they'll learn how to vlog and show you the whole video process. So today's actually our last day in Texas. Tomorrow we're flying back home, and I'm so excited because I really miss Isaac and the kitties. Yeah, we've been gone for 3 weeks, and it's been too long.